If we can go ahead and grab a hold of the four division world champion. Let's see. Hopefully we can go ahead and grab Mikey Garcia. Always a pleasure to speak with him and the boxing tradition that he has. Appreciate all of you staying with us here on Instagram Live. We had this couple of weeks ago with Keith Thurman, but we got Thurman 2 weeks ago, and I have no doubt we will go ahead and get Mikey Garcia in here sooner rather than later. So bear with us, guys. We hope to go ahead and grab Mikey. And Tay Jones, great to see you, my guy. It is always a pleasure. Elie Seckbach doing an excellent job. I'm on the PBC account, so we do follow each other. So how are you to everybody again? Waiting on Mikey Garcia, guys. Here we go. He says, what's up, guys? Let me go ahead and try to grab Mikey and just go ahead and there we go. Invitation to him. And let's go ahead and get Mikey Garcia on if we have the four division world champion. We are connecting. There's Mikey. How are you, my man? How's everything? Finally got you. Oh, you can't hear me? I believe my all right, so Mikey he's working on his audio issues. Once Mikey goes ahead and corrects his audio issues, he will come back and join us. It was great to see him. He's enjoying himself and trying to stay safe from what is happening with the coronavirus. Again, we hope all of you and your families are okay and safe during these trying times. I can hear anyone that I speak to, so hopefully we can go ahead and grab Mikey Garcia on sooner rather than later. Again, this is what happens when you deal with, you know, we're trying to make things happen here during quarantine season. Not the easiest thing in the world, but we will go ahead and get happy. So let's go ahead and try to grab Mikey Garcia one more time. Mikey is, I know we have a lot of questions to go ahead and ask Mikey Garcia. I am taking questions right now until the four division world champion goes ahead and join us. And if you guys have any questions, right, by all means, send them off. I went ahead, took the headset off. So there we go. He's back. And let's go ahead and go live. All right. Hopefully, Mikey will be able to go ahead and hear me where you're connecting once again. Mikey, can you hear me? Can you hear me, Mikey? Can you talk for us? Hello? Mikey, can you hear me? I cannot hear you, but I don't know what's going on. Maybe you turn on the your volume up or anything like that, because if you can go ahead and do that, Mikey, hopefully we can go ahead and speak with the four division world champion. Hey, Mikey, can you go ahead and do, let's see what we got now. Well, now Mikey is frozen, so... There we go. I hear something. There we go, Mike.
I can hear you now. There you are.
All right. Perfect, my man. Well, thank you very much for joining us, Mikey. It is a pleasure to join you. Thank you very much for joining us. Let's go ahead and get into some conversations. Mikey, how are you doing? How is your family with what is going on with the coronavirus? Are you guys safe? Are you guys okay? Everyone that you know, are they okay and safe? And have they been plagued by this at all?
Yeah, well, we've been staying safe. You know, we've been staying home most of the time. My parents are well, and I actually got to see them yesterday. I had been quite a few, you know, weeks without seeing my parents, but they came by to say hello. Yesterday was my daughter's birthday. My daughter's birthday turned 13.
No, happy birthday to her.
Yeah, thank you. So we're just here at home, just us. You know, everybody through phone calls and FaceTime and whatnot. But for the most part, we're okay. It's unfortunate, you know, that we have to do things this way right now instead of getting together like we normally do as a joining together for a big party or whatever. But, you know, we do what we can right now to keep our spirits up.
Well, Mikey, let's talk about your last fight that you had with Jesse Vargas. It was an excellent performance by you on February 29th. You knocked him down in the fifth, en route to the decision victory. What did you learn from that fight against Jesse Vargas down in Texas?
Well, you know, it was a good fight. He came in to win. You know, he put up a great effort. He was complicating things with the height and reach, just like we expected. But once I started getting the timing and the rhythm of things, I felt more comfortable, and I was able to take control of the pace and the fight. And I hurt him, but he got back up. He fought back. He was always dangerous, you know. So something that I could say I learned is that, you know, I'm obviously risking a lot more fighting at a welterweight division. Bigger guys can always be dangerous. You know, I could definitely feel the size difference in the ring, but you know, we got the win. We feel that's all I need to do, you know, to show everybody that I can be a key player at the welterweight limit. I need to make sure that I can win, and that's what we did. You know, I don't want to risk, you know, a loss, you know, trying to get the knockout. So we played it safe. I think it was a good call, and I know I have the abilities to do so, even at welterweight.
Mikey, you have said that your father and your brother, Robert, obviously the esteemed trainer, former world champion, that they have said they feel your best weight is at 140. But yet you seem to be steadfast in campaigning in the welterweight division. Why is it? Is it a case the bigger names are at 47, bigger financial opportunities are there? Are those the main reasons why you are not necessarily going against your brother and your dad, but you're kind of doing things the way you see fit for yourself?
Well, I do want to secure a title at 47. You know, being a fifth division title holder would be, you know, amazing for my career, for my legacy. You know, I think that's really what is pushing me, you know, to continue, you know, at 147. I really want to get that fifth world title. I think I have what it takes to do so. I got to earn my shot. I got to get in line and make something happen. And once people are able to see me, you know, at 147 and fighting another world title fight, I think I'll take advantage and show everybody there's a lot more to Mikey Garcia than what they've seen in the past. I do feel that 140 would be a better fit, better natural fit. But it's just one of those things where I know that the champions are also held by a different entity, and it's going to be a lot more complicated to secure a world title fight. Two of the belts are held by Ramirez, who's also a stablemate, you know, friend of mine. We're obviously not going to be fighting each other. So it just complicates things at 140. And if there's no title fight at 140 available, then what am I going to do there? You know, I'd rather, you know, secure and reach for a title at 147.
And that would be unprecedented for you to be able to be a five-division world champion. You've been a pro since 2006, going on your 14th year. Do you still have the same love for boxing? Do you still have the same, you know, as they talk about, that fire in the belly that you had when you were, you know, years ago when you were fighting at 26 and 30?
Look, it's actually changed. It's a little funny that when I first started boxing, I didn't really have that love or that fire. It kind of was just like something to do, and I it was good at it. It was natural. It's part of the family business. So here I am. But when I took the layoff and I went through my troubles, coming back kind of ignited that fire, that love. You know, it was taken away for a few years. Now that I have it back, there's a lot more I want to accomplish. There's so much more to show the world that I can be one of the best of this generation, of this era. And in order to do so, I got to challenge myself. I got to fight the world champions that are there and take on the biggest fights that people want to see me in. And so that's the funny part. Like I said, it's changed. Normally, a lot of times for the fighters, it's the other way around, mm-hmm. where maybe as they get older, they lose that fire, they lose that passion. But for me, it was backwards. Now I have that passion. I'm not done. I'm excited. There's so much more I want to accomplish. I was looking forward to fighting, you know, three times this year. That might not happen with, you know, the current issues that we're going through. But, you know, I want to fight a lot more. I'm not done. I got many more years to go. And then that's what keeps me going, because I know there's so much more I can accomplish. And I believe I will accomplish everything before I retire.
Well, let's talk about some of those big name matchups. I know that you have mentioned you want a fight with Manny Pacquiao. Also, you have discussed the fact of, you know, even though that he didn't go your way and you suffered the first blemish on your career, but that you would want a rematch with Errol Spence. Let's go back about a year ago, 14 months ago, when you fought Errol Spence at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. A wonderful atmosphere, over 47,000 fans, close to 50,000. What did you learn in that fight against Errol Spence?
Well, you know, it was a great fight, a great performance by him. You know, he fought, you know, the perfect fight. You know, he really knew how to box as a southpaw stance, kept the right distance. I felt like I was going to be able to get on the inside or maybe use, you know, lateral movement, but I just wasn't able to. He was able to just always be a step ahead. You know, he was a step quicker, you know, a step better in every way. You know, I knew he was going to be a tough fight. A tough fighter. He does everything so well. I kept saying, he reminds me a lot about me. There's nothing flashy and nothing special that stands out in Errol Spence. But everything he does it very well, very effective. A lot similar to the way I fight. But he was obviously a lot better, and he was bigger guy, longer reach, the height, that and he knew how to use it. He didn't give it up. You know, whenever I tried to get on the inside a little bit, whenever I tried to walk forward, he walked back and keep the distance. And whenever I tried to box on the outside, he would walk forward just enough to be at a distance that he was able to tag me with and land punches and combinations. Am I back?
Mikey,
am I back?
Yeah, you're back.
he was able to always, you know, dictate that distance. So he fought a perfect fight. And I mean, what else can I learn? You know, hey, that's just boxing, you know? You gotta take what you learn from that loss and keep moving forward. And I think I want to earn my shot. I need to win, you know, a few fights, get another big fight, maybe a world title fight, and that would secure a rematch opportunity.
Well, let's talk about what could potentially be next. A name that you have been very vocal about has been that of Manny Pacquiao, the man who last July defeated Keith Thurman. So what is your thought process in regards to, you know, this potential fight with Manny Pacquiao? We had Keith Thurman on 2 weeks ago, and he said he feels that he deserves a rematch against Pacquiao. With where you stand right now and being very vocal about calling out Manny Pacquiao and believing that it is stylistically a fantastic fight for you, what is your mindset about potentially fighting Manny Pacquiao? Have you heard anything about his interest on potentially fighting you? Or where do you stand right now when it comes to a potential matchup against the 8-division world champion in Manny Pacquiao?
Oh, I mean, I would love an opportunity to fight Manny. You know, I think even though he is a southpaw, he's not quite the boxer to use that. Like Errol, like the height. He doesn't have the height and reach advantages like Errol. So I think that makes it a better fight for me, you know, where I know he's going to engage. I know he's going to fight hard. He's a great fighter. He's a living legend, you know, and I would love to add something like that to my resume. You know, fighting, you know, the great Manny Pacquiao would be, you know, tremendous for my legacy. And if I'm capable of securing a victory over him, you know, that definitely adds to what I want to accomplish, you know, that legacy, those big triumphs. You know, I'm excited. If we can get that fight, that'd be the best fight. I know there's other opportunities for him. There's other options. You mentioned Keith, you know, maybe Errol Spence, maybe, you know, other names, you know, in the division like Danny Garcia or anybody else. I'm sure all these are big fights for Manny. Like I said, I would love an opportunity as well. I think it would be a terrific fight. The fan base would love that. I think I have a lot of fans. He's obviously the biggest draw. So I think it'll be a terrific fight. And if I can get that, I mean, I'm definitely taking care of business. I'm not gonna let this pass by, you know. I hope we can secure that and look forward to it. I mean, there's nothing bad that can go. I mean, I think I can fight very well. I feel that my boxing style can complicate things a lot for him, similar to the way Marquez complicated things for Manny, all those fights.
Do you see yourself as this generation's Marquez with the way you fight? I see a lot of similarities in the both of you, in the sense that you're both intelligent fighters. You're a wonderful counter puncher. You have a fantastic jab. Do you see some of, do you feel like you have some attributes that Marquez possessed, which obviously were very beneficial for him in the fourth fight against Pacquiao?
I mean, I guess I do have similar attributes. You know, we can both box effectively, counterpunch, be efficient. You know, there are some similarities, but I don't see myself like that. I mean, that's maybe for you or for other analysts, yeah, you know, to say. I've always been a fan of Marquez. I've always been a fan of Juan Manuel Marquez. He's my number one guy. I love him before he fought Manny. You know, when he was up and coming, I used to watch him, and he was such a beautiful boxer, very defensive, very effective counter puncher, and would only engage when he felt the moment right. Later in his career, he became a little more aggressive, a little more on the offensive side, and that's what drew a lot of fans towards him. But I already loved him even before that, you know. So I mean, I have nothing but, you know, big respects to Marquez. I, like I said, I don't want to emulate or say that I'm the next Marquez, but I could see some of the resemblance. You know, I'm effective, I'm smart, counterpunch, you know, and that's worked. You know, it works for my style. It may not be the most exciting style, you know, with, like the flashiness, you know, with the fastest hands or the craziest footwork, but it's effective and it works. You know, I couldn't do that against Errol Spence, like I said, but it fought the best guy at 147. You know, the best resume at 147, and that's okay. You know, you learn. You know, I learned from that. Just like Marquez when he fought Floyd, you know, he kept going.
Well, that night when you fought Spence, the fans came out. They were very supportive of you, along with Spence as well. But do you feel the love from the Mexican fight fans that when you came back to the sport, and especially, you know, you knocked out Dejan?